commit to jumping. Get a piece of this bread pudding, wake up.
On the mound, the legendary Leroy Satchel Paige. Arguably the greatest pitcher this sport has ever seen. We know for certain the oldest rookie in the history of Major League Baseball. Now, Major League Baseball says that Satchel was 42 years old when he finally got his opportunity to pitch in the Major Leagues with then the Cleveland Indians. Most who knew Satchel believe that he was at least 10 years older than he claimed to be. Satchel was likely born into the early to mid-1890s in Mobile, Alabama. And so that birth record was typically kept in the back page of the family Bible. And according to Satchel, the goat ate that page out the Bible. His original tombstone has a question mark by his birthday. Yeah, the old man literally took it with him to his grave. But when we talk about Satchel Paige, there is really no one to compare him to. Not someone who combines the longevity. By his estimation, he pitched in over 2,600 games. The great stuff. Recorded some 55 no-hitters and only God knows how many strikeouts. And the charisma. He could sell it. Yeah, he could sell it, but he could also back it up. There will never, ever, ever be another Leroy Satchel Paige.
Here's the third baseman, Hayes. The wind of the pitch. That's in there, and that's how this game gets started. Next pitch misses way outside. Satchel kicks and delivers. And another ball. Singy, I can't imagine batters enjoyed facing Satchel Paige. That high leg kick, so distracting and tough to figure out. Blows the high heat past him. That's a strikeout. Glass digs in now. Base knock center field. So they get a man aboard with a one out single.
Oh, that started and ended pretty quickly. No messing around right there. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride and load out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
Satchel comes to the plate. And a good eye there.
Yeah, that leg kick really messes with the hitter's timing. And if you can get past that and find the release point somehow, you still got to hit some of the best stuff any pitcher's ever had.
Glass leads off first with one away. And down on strikes. Satchel really humming down. Man at first. And now Bates. First pitch doesn't find the zone.
A pitcher like Satchel who can change speeds, run it into triple digits, or get you out on that front foot with a changeup, you just hope you run into one and make contact.
And the righty deals. Strike on the inside corner. Foul ball still, a 1-2 count. Swings and misses. Slider got him for strike three. All set for the start of the inning. And now the catcher comes up to him. Hughes. There's a strike. And he's down 0-2 as he swings through it. Cut on and miss. Struck him out. Paige dominant.
Satchel famously had names for his pitches. So he didn't have fastball, curveball, changeup. No, not Satchel. Satchel had what he called his midnight creeper. He had the two-humper. He had the bat dodger. He had the hesitation pitch. He had the long time, the short time, the jump ball, the trouble ball, the radio ball, the wobbly ball, the dipsy-doo. And he also had a pitch that he famously called his B-ball. You know why he called it the B-ball? Because Satchel says, it bees where I want it to be when I want it to be there. And so he had all the stuff you needed to be a star, and he was just that. He was not only the Negro League's biggest and brightest star, but he was one of the biggest stars in baseball history.
Okay, all set to go. Now the third baseman, Hayes. The pitch. That's off the mark, and away we go this afternoon. Next pitch downstairs. Two balls, no strikes, the count. Misses with the 2-0, and he's fired three straight outside the strike zone. There's a strike, 3-1. Chris, it must have been so difficult hitting Satchel with so many different out pitches. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Yeah, a pitcher with two or three out pitches is an ace these days. Satchel had closer to a dozen. Dig in against someone like that, you're just guessing every pitch, especially with his amazing command.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Cy Perkins caught Satchel for a lot of seasons, and for a while, he wouldn't even give signs. He'd just hold up the mitt, and Satchel would hit it.
Glass tries to check his swing. Now a look to third. No swing. Eric Summersgill with the call. Got him looking. Paige notches the strikeout. And here is Smith. And the first pitch misses for ball one. To the right side. There's one. On to O'Neill for the inning-ending double play. And welcome back. Stepping in, the long ball threat, Bates. Paige back to work.
1-0.
The 1-0 from Satchel. Just missed.
2-0.
And 2-0 is in for a strike. This to center field. Newman settles underneath it. Drops into the glove. And there's one down. Hughes now at the plate as he swings through strike one. Paige winds and fires. struck him out. The Midnight Creeper claims another victim. Two outs, base is empty. McDonald now at the plate. Check swing, but he went too far. Slider right there. Oh, and two as he waves at that one. On the ground, right side. On to O'Neill. And that is that.
They clocked Satchel Paige unknowingly in a ball game in Griffith Stadium in D.C. Satchel retires the side, and the kid from the military comes over. Mr. Paige, we clock your fastball at 105 miles per hour. Satchel looks at the kid. He says, son, I wish I'd known you were timing me. I could have thrown harder than that. Yeah, you'll hear from the old Negro League players who saw Satchel in his prime that if anyone tells you they saw his fastball in the hitting zone, they're lying. Yeah, you might have seen it leave his hand, but by the time it got there to home plate, it literally was about the size of an aspirin tablet.
When you say you ride for me, ride for me. When you say you die for me, die for me. Is it a forever thing, ever thing? No matter what ever brings. When you say you always down, always down. When you say you hold my crown, hold my crown.
All right, ready to go here. Leading off, Harvey. The pitch. That one's in there. And this one is off and running. Next offering is fouled back. Satchel kicks and delivers. The B-ball for the strikeout. Can't hit what you can't see.
They gon' throw socks on my knee, meet me warm till I'm finished, till it wall full of faces, I'm calling me God. Welcome to the jungle, it's what happens.
Stepping in, Gordon.
Boog, how about that no-hitter Satchel threw against the New York Black Yankees in 1932?
One of the greatest single-game performances ever. Now this is in the air down the line. Sanders makes the play. Runner tags from third. Just ahead of the throw, he scores. And they trail by one. So digging in, Gordon. The pitch. 0-1.
Boog, how about that no-hitter Satchel threw against the New York Black Yankees in 1932?
One of the greatest single-game performances ever. Next offering is downstairs. In that game on the mound, he had 11 strikeouts, and at the plate, he had two hits. Only three other pitchers in Major League history have ever done that, and one of them was Hall of Famer Catfish Hunter. The B-ball absolutely humming. That's a K. And the batter now, Parker. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Next offering is in for a strike.
He's looking for a ground ball to get a double play and out of this jam.
Satchel comes to the plate. Another B-ball for the K. And the batter will be the shortstop, Floyd. This one popped up. Foul ground, first base side. And Buck calls it in for the out.
Stop it, please. Stop that. about gender, racial wealth, the pressure I built for myself, for all of the people who picks on my grandmama's shelf, who heard her say, give me the belt. I would imagine when...
What really made Satchel so special was 105 with pinpoint control. He could put it exactly where he wanted to put it, and I'm not talking about just throwing strikes. The catcher set the target. He hit the target. He didn't miss. You see, he didn't warm up in the bullpen like most pitchers do, throwing to the catcher across home plate. You know what Satchel would use? A stick of foil chewing gum wrapper. The catcher would sit the chewing gum wrapper on top of home plate. And wherever the catcher moved the chewing gum wrapper, Satchel right over the top of that chewing gum wrapper. And as Satchel would say, he'd work both corners of that chewing gum wrapper. He was absolutely uncanny.
Ready to get underway. Now the left fielder, Harvey. The wind of the pitch. Bunting for a hit, and he grabs it foul. That hits the dirt, and it's 1-1.
1-1.
There's a strike. A lot of pitchers with great command or great velocity, but having both is so rare. Satchel was one of the special few. Him looking. Fastball at the letters throws him for strike three. And the batter now, Marshall. In there, and it's 0-1.
I mean, 105 with the ability to spot it all over the place, just ridiculous. You know, Ryan Helsley dialed it up to 104 miles per hour in 2022. To think Satchel was doing it 80, 90 years before that is just crazy.
Next offering is in for a strike.
One ball, two strikes.
Got it by him for the K. Two outs, base is empty. Digging in, Reese. And first offering is fouled off. That one a triple digits. No score, just getting started. Top of the first. Next pitch is in the dirt, and it's 1-2. Got him. Strikes out the side to begin the game.
One of my favorite Satchel Paige stories involves the old man pitching in the Denver Post tournament. They're playing an all-white semi-pro team. The first kid from the semi-pro white team gets into the batter's box. Satchel throws him a fastball. He dribbles it down the third baseline. It stays fair. The kid beats it out, gets an infield hit. Well, about that time, one of the kids from the opposing team steps into the dugout steps and says, "Let's beat him. He ain't nothing but an overrated darkie." Well, Satchel Paige had a nickname for everyone. His nickname, famously for the legendary Buck O'Neill, was Nancy. That's a whole nother story. But anyway, Satchel looks over at first base and he says, "Nancy, did you hear that?" Buck said, "Yes, Satchel, I heard it." He said, "Nancy, bring him in." So Buck turns and motions for the outfield to take a couple steps in. Satchel looks over at first base. He says, "Nancy, bring him all the way in." Honest to God's truth, there were seven guys kneeling around the mound. And Satchel strikes out the side on 9 straight pitches. He looks into the opposing team's dugout and says, "Overrated darkie, hey." But the legendary Buck O'Neill always said, if he had one game to win, and any choice of any pitcher from any era, it would be the legendary Satchel Paige. He says you might beat him when he was out there messing around, but when he was locked in, forget about it.
And now, Cole. The pitch. Swings through that one for strike one. Swing and a miss. One down on a 3-pitch strikeout. Here's the third baseman, Gordon. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing and one. Singy, the audacity Satchel had in this game, just daring the batters to put one in play. It's the showmanship that made him famous and the sheer skill that made him great. That's 2 straight strikeouts on 6 pitches. At the plate, Parker swings through that one, 0-1.
This wasn't even the only time he did it. Satchel had some barnstorming games where they'd bring in one more fielder every inning until it was just him and the catcher out there.
Got him! Who needs a defense behind you anyway?
Now, Major League Baseball says that Satchel was 42 years old when he finally got his opportunity to pitch in the major leagues in 1948 with the Cleveland Indians. He, along with Larry Doby, would help Cleveland win the last World Series at that time that Cleveland had won. Many thought Satchel should have been named Rookie of the Year. He goes 6-1 with a 2.4 ERA his rookie season. At age 42, which means he might have been closer to 52.
And in comes Cleveland's ageless Satchel Paige to mount the mound for the trial.
Then another kiss, then another kiss, then a covered dish with white rice, greens, and smothered fish. I'm lying, it was just chicken. I'm studying it. Now we got a covenant. It's on the bomb for life.
life. In all my years, this was the easiest song to write. It's my confession in the rhyme, a testament, and I just want to do my thing as I talk about a feeling that cannot be explained or loved.
Back here at the ballpark, and now the right fielder, Rose. The wind and the pitch. So here comes Satchel to replace Cleveland's ace, Bob Lemon. Hey. Next offering is in for a strike.
Heck of an assignment to draw on your MLB debut, Boog, and even more so at Satchel's age, whatever it is.
So now one ball, two strikes. Satchel into his motion. The long windup turns on the rubber, kicks and fires. Swing and a miss for the strikeout. He swung over top of the curveball. Here's the center fielder, Leonard. And he swings and misses at the initial offering. Swing and a miss. Oh, and he lost the handle on that one. Next offering misses. Now 1-2. Paige winds and fires. Fights it off, you'll see another. Next pitch off the play. It's 2-2. And down on strikes he goes. The ageless rookie sets down another. Now here is Green. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing and one. And that one fouled off. And a swing and a miss. Down on strikes. Satchel gets through his first MLB frame unscathed.
And I do the best that I can to attain it. If we gotta gamble, I bet on myself, all that other dangerous. I just made a way for myself from my west and my grandma's basement. So I think you do about in the presence of greatness. Let's we talking about generational wealth, the pressure I feel for myself. All of the people who fix on my grandma's shelf, who heard to say, give me the belt. I would imagine when they call it manifestation, a man would get taken away. We wasn't planning vacation like internet band.
Welcome back. Now at the plate, Michaels. Well, Satchel's a rookie today, but he's got a long professional history in Cleveland. Splits the plate, and that is strike one. Back in 1931, Satchel pitched 5 games with the Cleveland Cubs, and then, of course, he pitched in Cleveland with other teams, particularly the Pittsburgh Crawfords. Next offering upstairs.
Yeah, those Crawfords teams of the early 30s, Boog, right up there with the best ever in baseball.
That's right. Paige, Josh Gibson, Oscar Charleston, Judy Johnson, Cool Papa Bell. Just ridiculous. And a swing and a miss. And one out now. So up next, Sherman. Corner infielders guarding the lines, trying to prevent extra bases. Check swing, went around, and it's 0-1. Next pitch is outside. One ball, one strike. Satchel picks and delivers. Strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
In the dirt. Gets it to first. Oh. And that quickly, two away. And here is Kennedy. And that's in there for strike one. Next offering is in for a strike.
No balls, two strikes.
And now one and two. Next one in the dirt. Satchel comes to the plate. Caught him looking for the K. Bottom of the ninth. And now Harrison. And here it comes. And first offering is fouled off.
You know, this guy's great speed is in the back of that pitcher's mind. If he can get on, it's going to give him one more thing he's got to think about.
The next pitch misses, and a count even one and one. Swing and a miss. It's a ball and two strikes. And downstairs. Next one misses, full count now. Waves at the bender for the strikeout. Now the catcher up to hit, Bates. He swings and misses at the first pitch, 0-1.
Trying to keep good speed off the bases.
Next one is off the plate, and the count is 1-1. Next offering is fouled back. Crowd locked in right now. One run game here in the ninth. And that's a strikeout looking. Frozen with the heater at the knees. So two down now, and here is Murray. One's in there, 0-1. Home team down a run here in the last half of inning number nine. Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now. The next offering misses, and a count 1-2. And that's the ball game.
Now, Satchel in 1965 is believed to be 59 years old, if you believe he was born in 1906, which I do not, but for the sake of this story, we'll say that he was indeed born in 1906. He pitches three shutout innings against the Boston Red Sox, giving up only one hit in those three innings. Great trivia question. Who got that lone hit off of Satchel? The legendary Carl Yastrzemski. Yaz. Yaz gets a double against the old man. Satchel leaves him at third, and shut down everybody else over three of the most remarkably pitched innings in baseball history. and they were all turning, going back into the dugout in utter disbelief that they couldn't hit that old man.
Ready to go now, and now it's going to be Hill. The pitch. In the dirt, and we are underway.
Ball one, no strike.
Satchel making him look foolish. Hill started after it, tried to hold up. Now a look to first, and Joe McDonald says he went around. Popped up. Benson makes the catch, and there's one down. Chris Satchel was 58 when he pitched this game, at least officially. We're both in our early 50s. I can't imagine how he did it. Swing and a miss. Strike one.
It's really unbelievable, Boog. Satchel would tell you a million different reasons why he was able to keep playing so long. Not sure which one of them I believe, though.
Next offering clips the zone count, even at two.
One of those rules of his was to avoid fried meats. That's one you live by, right, Boo?
Well, unless I'm in Philadelphia. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. And two away now. Now it's going to be Sherman. And it's fouled away. Paige winds and fires. Strike two.
No ball, two strikes.
No score, just getting started, top of the first. Cuts and misses, it's a strikeout. Back here at the ballpark, new inning getting started. Now it's the right fielder, Rose. And a pitch. That one the other way, and a base hit. Off to a good start with a leadoff dive.
Didn't exactly square that one up, but sometimes you don't have to. Kind of got it off the end of the bat, but he gets that knock because he was willing to go with the pitch on the outside part of the plate.
Leonard stands in now and watches strike one. And he's down 0-2 as he swings through it. Next pitch misses, and that's ball one. Satchel kicks and delivers. Liner, base hit. Lead runner holds up. They're at first and second with nobody out. Okay, all set to go. Here's the shortstop at the plate, Hill. Satchel making him look foolish. The next pitch misses, and that's ball one. To the left side, but it is well fouled. Chris Satchel was 58 when he pitched this game, at least officially. We're both in our early 50s. I can't imagine how he did it. Swing and a miss. Had him out front for strike three. Next to hit, Murray. Swings through that one, 0-1.
It's really unbelievable, Boog. Satchel would tell you a million different reasons why he was able to keep playing so long. Not sure which one of them I believe, though.
Next one misses, and a count 2-1.
One of those rules of his was to avoid fried meats. That's one you live by, right, Boog?
Well, unless I'm in Philadelphia. Up the middle. To first, quick start here this evening, two out, top of the first. In the air, left field. Snyder has a beat on it. Puts the squeeze on that one, and that'll end the inning. Welcome back. Top of the second. And now here is Rose. There's a strike.
0-1's the count.
Next offering misses, and now it's even 1-1. Swings through that one out in front that time. Next pitch is outside. Got him. Satchel just keeps rolling along. And now the center fielder, Leonard. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. They say it went. No score here in the second. Swing and a pop-up. Foul territory for the catcher. And he makes the catch. Two away. Palmer stands in but two away as he takes a ball. Next offering is in for a strike.
This lineup's going to have to find a way to make him work a little harder out there on the mound. I mean, he is just mowing him down. He's settling in. You got to make him uncomfortable. Maybe step out of the box, call timeout, do whatever it takes.
Next offering in the dirt. Two balls, two strikes. Next offering upstairs. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. The old man keeping these hitters in check. And welcome back. And now the first baseman, Santiago. But why to kick the pitch? Satchel comes to the plate.
Love how vocal the umpire is today. No doubt. In the hitter's mind, catcher's mind, and even the pitcher's mind. As to the conviction in the call.
Satchel into his motion. The long windup. Turns on the rubber. Kicks and fires. The punch out there. 59 years old, so they say. And he's still untouchable. Green, batting with one down. Takes a strike. Good contact guy. Good defender. Next offering is down low. Ball one. Next offering is in for a strike. Slider misses outside. Next pitch in the dirt, and the count's full. Set down on strikes. Called strike three and a fastball up in the zone. Moss will hit next. In there, and it's 0-1. Top of the third, no score.
Well, here's a chance to strike out the side right here with the pitcher at the dish. Just got to go right after this guy. Don't waste any pitches.
Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout.
Might just turn around to 180. I ain't politic and I ain't kissing no babies. The devil on my doorstep being so shady.
Without question, Satchel Paige was the Negro League's biggest and brightest star. The man would ride into towns and the entire towns would shut down to watch him pitch. Everyone wanted to see the old man do his thing. Was he a little bit disheartened when he wasn't the first to break baseball's color barrier? Of course he was, because in many ways, he was the Negro Leagues. And I'm not sure there's any more lore or legend surrounding any one athlete. Perhaps it's because we don't really know how old he truly was, and because he dazzled us for decades. By the time he ended his career, he was either 59 or maybe 69 years old, and he was still getting it done. Only the immortal Leroy Satchel Paige.